Welcome back. So guys, welcome back. I want to give you some tips for gift items for this Yuletide. If you are interested, you keep watching. Hello and welcome back to my channel. I am Nke God Jimmy. Merry Christmas in advance. I'm happy to be here. So, a while ago, I was saying something. You know, in the spirit of the season, a lot of people may want to give out gift items, but they will be like, what am I going to give? I don't even have much. But you really have the mind to give. You don't need to have much. The heart with which you give out is what really matters. And that is what this season is all about. It's all about showing love and meeting the need of some persons you know that they really need this help. So I'm here to give you some tips on what and what you should be considering. So if you see me looking here and there or down, just know that I am looking through my list just so that we get it very straight. And please, if you have not subscribed to this channel, what are you still waiting for? I beg you in God's name, subscribe to this channel and help this ministry, okay? Help the ministry to move forward. It doesn't cost you anything to subscribe. You just what? Subscribe and you become part of this family. Okay, that being said, let's quickly dive into the business of the day. So, the first thing on my list here will be what? Footwears. It doesn't matter. It could be slippers. We have a lot of plastic. We have a lot of rubber stuffs in the market now. Very fanciful, very beautiful. You can give them, can just buy them, go to the place where they sell them wholesale, make a random pick, and you buy them and give out. Those people will appreciate it. I remember buying footwear and wrapper, and that is going to be the next point. The next gift item will be what? Wrapper. Just as you can afford. I'm not saying you should buy all of these things. I'm just pointing them out. Whichever one you can, just lay your hand on. Back some years ago, I bought wrapper and footwear for a woman who actually had a husband and her children. But I just feel that, okay, I am led to give this woman this thing, and I don't know what actually I will give to her, but I have always seen her in the church wearing one particular clothes, and I say, what am I going to do? So I have to go buy wrapper. It was Christmas season and footwear, and I gave to this woman. She and her husband never stopped blessing me. I'm telling you, I never knew that what I did was even going to in any way bring joy, but my heart just said I should do it. Okay, so we have the footwears, we have the wrappers, whichever one you can afford. Then the next one will be used clothes or used utensils. There are some of us that have a lot of clothes that are lying so dormant in our boxes, in our wardrobes, and you don't know what to do with them. Some even go ahead to burn them. No, you don't burn them. There are people that when you give this thing out to them in this season, they will so bless you. And I also want to bring it here that you don't wait until season like this before you bless people. But then, it's also not bad to go ahead doing that. So instead of you burning those clothes, those used utensils, you have replaced new ones, and you don't know, you just want to throw them away, or you want to just burn them, gather them. There are people you can give them to, and they also appreciate you. I mean, you know, the clothes that are not torn, they are still what? Presentable. It's either they are slimmer than you are now, bigger, you know, or out of trend. There are people that goes with things that are trendy. Just package them and give to these people, and they will bless you. So the next one will be umbrella. That's for our old mamas and old papas. We are entering into the dry season. The hot weather is here. It's a part of the country anyway. There are people that have already started experiencing the heat, but where I am, it is still rainy here. So you could also get that. Handbags. It could be okay bags, it could be designer's bag, whichever bag it is, small, medium, big, nursing mothers, young ladies, old mamas, you can reach out to them. Okay, the next one will be beverages. You can lay your hand on beverages and you give to whosoever, they will bless you. It's also a beautiful gift item to give away. Then we have vitamins and blood tonic. That's for those of us that have aged mothers and fathers, uncles and aunties. This can actually come handy. There is this particular blood tonic I normally get for my grandpa when he was still alive. They call it Buntu. Yes, Buntu. It has this brown container. Yes, very, very, very good. Or you can also go for Astimine. These are two basic blood tonics that I know that are very fine. And to it, you can add any kind of vitamins, okay, fruits, and all of it. So, I am not a medical person, but what I have used that have worked for me and the person that I have given them to is what I am also telling you. So you can also, the next item will be soap, bathing soap, washing soap, soap of any range. If you are traveling to any part of the villages in Africa, these things that I'm mentioning, like soap, there are some people that cannot afford good soap. Let them remember that it was when Lisa came for December, when Nnamdi came for December, when Felix came for December, that he gifted us these things, that she gifted us these things. It doesn't matter whether you are married or single, but provided some money, some cash are coming into your hand and you want to travel, you can get some of these things. They can actually be very, very handy, and these people will appreciate it. Okay, the next one will be cream. As you are buying soap, you can buy cream. We have a lot of cream that are very, very, very cheap. You could go for Vaseline if you are not sure of this hydroquinone content. Of course, when you want to buy, you check the hydroquinone content. You can go with Vaseline, you can go with Pierre's lotion, you can go with Shield, you can go with Venus. You know, these old creams, they still have this, their old quality in them and very fine in scent. You go for those kind of creams. Then, if you can also afford foodstuff, rice, beans, yam, any of them, you buy, share them into portions and dish out raw food, not cooked one. Me, I'm not the kind of person that cook on any celebration time and share, as in my neighbor have given me and I also give. I don't appreciate that. But when you give me something that is raw, something that is tangible, any of these things that I've mentioned, I will always remember, because I appreciate gifts so much, and I'm sure a lot of people do also with what they see with their eyes, compared to when you give them money, which is actually the last on my list, giving out money. When you give out money, it's good, it's very good. But those persons who just use it without remembering, you know, it's just like the thing just vanishes. But if you use that money you want to give and buy those items, the items may not even be costly, and you give it to them. And instead of giving 5,000, you add 2,000 on top of the item you want to give to some particular set of persons. and you know, it's fine. And any other thing that you think is you can afford but it's not in this list, okay, you could pay visit to prison. Prisoners are really suffering. There are some persons that are in the prison awaiting trial over 10 years, 15 years for what they did not do. And they are languishing, no food, no medical care. Instead of going to orphanage homes are good. But I feel that these orphanage homes have NGOs that really sponsors most of the things they do there compared to the prisoners. So please, as you share love this season, knowing fully well that Jesus is the reason for the season, we are celebrating God coming down in flesh to show us much love. Although there is nothing like Christmas celebration in the Bible, there is nothing like that. But it's just according to the history, then they use it to worship some goddess and whatever. And the Roman Catholic brought in that date, knowing that people that attend church also attend this. What do we do to bring these people back to the church? And that's how this celebration of Christmas came in. It is not as if it is biblical. Nobody knew. The Bible never recorded when Jesus was born, the date, the month, and all of it. So it is good to do what is good. In this season, remember, it is love that matters. Okay? Till I see you in my next vlog. Watch other vlogs. I have dropped so many beautiful things that you may want to see in this season. Please subscribe to my channel. Till I see you in the next vlog, I remain Nke God Chimi. With love from me to you, remain blessed. See you more healthier.